Hi everyone, here we will see electrical machines lab 2 experiment 2 speed control of DC motor by armature and field control. Next, aim of this experiment: to control the speed of DC shunt motor by armature control method and field flux control method. Operators are required. So these are the following operators are required to conduct this experiment: voltmeter, ammeter, rheostats, tachometer. So each one is required one quantity, and range and type is mentioned in the table. Next, this is circuit diagram of the speed control of DC shunt motor experiment. Next, we will see the procedure of armature control method. First one, connections are made as shown in the circuit diagram. Keep the rheostat R1 in the field circuit of motor in cutout position. The rheostat R2 in the armature circuit of the motor in cut-in positions. The supply switch S1 is closed. The field current IF is adjusted to a constant value by adjusting the rheostat R1, and rheostat R2 is gradually cut out in steps, and each step the readings of voltmeter and speed are noted down. The above procedure is repeated for another value of field currents. All rheostats are brought back to their respective original positions, and supply switch S1 is opened after taking all the readings. Next, we will see the field flux control method. Keep the rheostat R1 in field circuit of motor in cutout position. The rheostat R2 in the armature circuit of the motor in cut in position. The supply switch S1 is closed. The rheostat R2 is adjusted to get the required voltage across the armature. The rheostat R1 gradually brought to cut in steps, and each step the readings of ammeter and speed are noted down. So here we have one note: rheostat R1 is in cut in till the speed is little above the rated speed of motor. The experiment is repeated for other values of armature voltage. All rheostats are brought back to their initial positions, and supply switch S1 is opened. The graphs are plotted in model graph 1 and 2, we can observe. So next, we'll see the demonstration of the experiment.
The motor and connections are made as per the circuit diagram. Now we will demonstrate the experiment according to the procedure. Switch on the DPST switch. Start the motor by 3-point starter. So motor is not running. Why? Because its field resistance and armature resistance are maximum. That's what this motor is not running. So adjust the field rheostat, set the field current in ammeter, and adjust the armature rheostat. Now motor is running, so armature resistance is reduced. note down the voltmeter and ammeter. And speed values. Again, vary the armature resistance step by step. Note down the voltmeter and speed values in the tabular column. Maximum position, bring the field of start to summer position. So now the field current is 0.7 amperes, earlier is 0.9 amperes. So repeat the procedure. So this is the armature control of DC motor. We will demonstrate the field control method. So field control method, so field current is will be variable, armature voltage is fixed, so set the armature voltage some value. So V1 is equal to 200 volts. And put down the field current and speed of the induction of the DC motor by using tachometer. Again, vary the field rheostat step by step. Note down the field current and speed by adjusting the armature rheostat. Set the armature voltage some other value. So now V2 is equal to 180 volts. So repeat the procedure in earlier case. Plot the graph for both armature voltage control method and field control method. In armature voltage control, so armature voltage versus speed. In field control method, field current versus speed. Next, bring back the rheostats to original positions. Release the PSQ switch.
This is the experiment demonstration. Tabular column for armature control method. In armature control method, field current is fixed and armature voltage will be variable. So we have to do for this method two cases, case 1 and case 2. Next, field flux control method. In this method, armature voltage is fixed, field current will vary with respect to speed. So similarly, here also we have to do this method for two cases, case 1 and case 2. Next, these are the model graphs for both armature and field control methods. So this is the graph for our experiment readings, armature voltage control and field flux control methods. So the result of the experiment is, the experiment after connecting after calculating the readings and graph. So at last we have to write the result. Hence, conducted the experiment on the speed control of DC shunt motor by armature control method, field flux control method. The graphs are plotted, speed versus field current and speed versus armature voltage. Next, these are the expected viva questions on this experiment. So you prepare answers for these questions. Next, thank you everyone.